So, how many of you have given ragging or have heard about any funny ragging incidents in your life? Oh, so I've got 100%. So that's fine, I'm blessed. I've got a super cool audience. So, hello my fellow Toastmasters and my super cool anonymous judges. See, that wasn't me, okay? That was the guy who was being ragged. That was the guy whose sound mode was on, and that was the guy who was on third button mode. So I want to take you all to this journey of my ragging which I had, okay? So starting off with start, this sound mode on, which means in ragging is, whatever question senior will ask you, you have to answer by using your musically mode on. Which means, like, what is your name?
My name is Rahul.
Where are you from?
Lucknow.
Do you have any girlfriend?
No.
Okay, so this was about the sound mode is on. And third button is like, whenever senior looks at you and whenever he talks to you, you don't have the courage to talk to you. So the rule number one is, you have to be on a third button mode. Third button mode is, this is the button number one, button number two, and this is button number three. You have to see here and you have to answer the question. So this is how my journey started. Hello my dear friends, I am Rahul Anand, and I'm going to share my funny incidents of ragging. So at the end of the speech, if I'm able to take any one of you to witness the funny incident that I had, not only by hearing the speech, but actually I want to take you in that moment, then I'll be really honored. Okay, so the day starts with day one. I went to the college, and this was about the time like hostel allotment. So the hostel has been allotted to me, and I was super excited. Like, I went to a new city and I have got a really good rank. So I have got a government college, okay? So the best part about government college is less fee, okay? And the worst part about government college is there are committees, but they are not actually working properly. Even there are the heads of the committee, they are not bothered about anything, okay? So I was thinking, like, I'm in a new city, I'll be thrilling, I'll be doing so much fun. There will not be any people like my parents, they will scold me or do anything. I am on my own. I'm going to Kingdom of Dreams. I'm going on the heaven. I'm going to the bright side of heaven, actually. Okay, but that was not the reality how it looks, okay? So I have got my room allotted to me, and there I have already got to know about ragging, the dark side of ragging, how it goes. Okay, so I have met some friends with me who are going to just take out their rooms with me. So I have two friends like Sunil and Amit. So I was going with both of them, and suddenly when I entered the hostel, there was a sound. There was a scary sound came. You know what that sound is? I knew that these are seniors. So what I have done, I have just told them, just walk fast because there are seniors. So what they have done, they have started walking faster. And then again, the sound came. The sound got increased. I have told Sunil, don't look back. I have told to Atul, don't look back. Sunil told, Atul is not there. Just turn around and just go again. Find Sunil and prevent him. I have told to Sunil, it's been 5 minutes only and we have met Sunil. Just run, man. So after that, actually, I haven't seen Sunil, okay? So I think, yeah, maybe rest in peace, Sunil. God bless him. Okay, so this is how my actual journey started with my hostel. And incident number two. So I have been got used to this ragging incidents, and there were some actually instruments. The instruments which we have got in our hostel area, in our room area, was a table. This is not like this type of table. It was for study purpose. So it was a square, and we used to use it for study purpose. And what our senior used to do? They used to sound it. So that was a sounding table. Sounding table means when they put two sounds, like tuck, tuck, then what you have to do? You have to take water, you have to take a bottle, you have to put water, which means seniors are thirsty, they want water. So you have to go. So I was living in room number 108. So the first floor was allotted to juniors, second floor was allotted to seniors, and the third floor was allotted to the big boss, super seniors. So back in that days, I was living in room number 108, and seniors, sounding table, tuck, tuck. I went out there, and then we had some conversation, and the senior told me, can you sing, can you do these things? So So I was able to do everything, okay? And then they told me, like, what you have learned in your college? What types of punishment, what you have learned in your school days? What types of punishment or humiliation you have seen in your school days? So I have told, nothing, I have been a Murga. Murga, you know, like this one. So they have told me, there is a technical part of guy. You are an engineer, you have to be a technical Murga. So they have told me one funny and one best side of humiliation of engineering. You have to be a technical Murga. So the Murga is outside in, the technical Murga is inside out. So I was a technical Murga at that point. And after that, my days were going and I was good at badminton. So one fine day, seniors have asked me to play badminton with them. So I was very much excited. Now I am going to be friends with seniors. Yeah. And suddenly they called me and they told, you have to play by your own. So I thought, like, maybe they want to play by just by myself or something, I don't know. And then suddenly they told, no, there will be no badminton, there will not be any shuttle, and you have to play on your own. So after that time, believe me guys, for 10 minutes, I was just doing service from here without any shuttle, without any badminton. I was just going there, I was just receiving the service, I was going there, I was doing smash, I was going there, and this went for around 10 minutes. And this way, like, the journey went, and I had some exciting incidents, so much super thrilling incidents which I can share you. And out of which I have created some very cool friends actually out there. And you know, girls, so I thought of, like, I had a friend which was girl, but that was not my girlfriend. So I thought, like, maybe after first semester I can maybe propose her or something. Yeah, you know. Okay, so after first semester, when my fresher party ended, I thought, like, yeah, it's the time, man. You are the man, you can do it, man. So I went out there and I thought, like, maybe I can. But before that, she has, you know what, friend zoned me. Okay. And after that, I thought, like, maybe there's still a time when I can do it. Yeah. But you know, after some time, the hell part, she has brother zoned me. Okay. So after that, the journey continues, and I had given my second semester examination, and my first year ended. And then again, I went to the hostel. This time, I was looking for someone to come on, and as I was a senior, so the journey continues, and yeah, over to you.